Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a ratio test problem, and with this one we've been given the function 2 to the k divided by k factorial, and we've been asked to determine whether or not this series converges or diverges. We're going to be using the ratio test to figure out whether or not the series converges or diverges. And remember that with the ratio test, what we're going to do is we're going to replace the variable in our function k with k plus 1 everywhere we see the variable, and then we're going to divide that by the original function, and we'll simplify and solve for a number. That number is going to be equal to what we'll call L, and whatever value we get for L is going to tell us whether or not this series converges or diverges. The reason we're going to use the ratio test is because the ratio test is really useful when we have factorials. So that's always a good place to start. If your function involves a factorial, you might want to try the ratio test if you're dealing with convergence tests and you need to determine whether or not the series that involves factorials converges or diverges. So what we'll do, like I said, is we'll plug in k plus 1. We'll replace k with k plus 1 everywhere in our original function. And we're going to be taking the limit as k approaches infinity of our new function here. So we're going to do 2 to the k plus 1 divided by k plus 1 factorial. And we're going to divide that entire function by our original function. So 2 to the k over k factorial. Now we're going to go ahead and simplify. And the goal again is to simplify to a single number that we can use to represent L. So remember that when we divide by a fraction, we can multiply by that fraction's inverse. So we'll have 2 to the k plus 1 divided by k plus 1 factorial. And instead of dividing by this fraction here, we'll multiply by the inverse. So we're going to multiply, and we're just going to flip that denominator upside down. So instead of 2 to the k over k factorial, we'll end up with k factorial over 2 to the k. Now we can go ahead and simplify. We're going to simplify these terms together, 2 to the k plus 1 and 2 to the k. We're going to look at those together, and then we're going to look at k plus 1 factorial and k factorial together. And you can group your terms together that way when you're dealing with a problem like this and you're looking to simplify. So the reason we can do that is because we'll have 2 to the k plus 1 divided by 2 to the k. Remember that when you're dealing with, and we'll write it over here, remember that when you're dealing with fraction like this, and the bases are the same, right? Both of them have a base of 2. They're raised to different exponents, but they both have a base of 2. You can subtract the exponent in the denominator from the exponent in the numerator. So the exponent from the numerator is k plus 1, and we'll subtract the exponent from the denominator, which is k. And again, we can do that because they are both raised to the base of 2. So what we'll have is k plus 1 minus k. Of course, the k's will cancel, k minus k, and we'll just be left with 1, which means our new exponent is going to be 1. And that, of course, is going to be in the numerator because the exponent here is larger than the exponent in the bottom. So what we're left with is 2 to the 1 in the numerator. So we've got 2 to the first power, or just 2 in the numerator. And then we'll have k factorial over k plus 1 factorial. Remember that with factorial, if we, for example, have 5 factorial, that's equal to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Or you can think about it as 5 times 5 minus 1 times 5 minus 2, right? Etc. So it's no different when we have a variable like k. So in the numerator, we've got k factorial. So that means we're going to have k times k minus 1 times k minus 2 times k minus 3. And we'll just go ahead and say dot, 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 right? Then in the denominator, we're starting with k plus 1, right? So we've got k plus 1. Well, the next term is going to be k plus 1 minus 1, which of course is just going to be k. Then we've got k plus 1 minus 1 minus another 1, right? We end up with k minus 1. And this pattern is just going to continue, k minus 3, dot, dot, dot. And so we've written out our factorial terms. The benefit from doing this is that, as you can see, we're going to get k and k to cancel here in the numerator and denominator. K minus 1 will cancel, k minus 2 will cancel, k minus 3 will cancel. And you'll see that if we keep going, we're going to get every term to cancel except for this original k plus 1 here. That's the only thing that's going to be left. So what we've shown now is that we can simplify this entire fraction here to 2 over k plus 1. And now that we've gotten to this point, all we need to do is go ahead and plug in infinity for k, right? If we do that, we'll get essentially infinity plus 1 in the denominator. And I'm just doing this to illustrate that what we end up with is infinity in the denominator. And we know from our work with sequences and series that whenever we have infinity in the denominator, right, that this is going to approach 0, right? 2 divided by infinity is going to approach 0. When the denominator gets extremely large or tends toward infinity, and you can do this on your calculator if the concept is kind of unclear, take 2 and divide it by 1 million or something. You'll get an extremely small number. Your series is going to tend toward 0, which means that 0 is going to be equal to L. And if we go ahead and look at our definition here of the ratio test, right, when we take 2 to the k plus 1 over k plus 1 factorial and we divide that by our original function, we simplify and we get this number L. In this case, we found that L is equal to 0. Well, what the ratio test tells us is that if L is less than 1, then the series converges absolutely. If L is greater than 1, then the series diverges. Of course, if L is equal to 1, then the test is inconclusive and we need to use a different convergence test. But in this case, we know that L is less than 1, right? It's 0, so it's less than 1, which means that this series converges absolutely. And we haven't found, remember, we haven't found the sum of the series. We've just used the ratio test to determine whether or not it converges or diverges, and the ratio test has proven to us that the series converges absolutely. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.